This is the first of three videos on solving systems of linear differential equations. Basically, derivative of a vector with respect to time is some matrix times a vector. In this video, we're going to talk about what happens when the eigenvalues are real. Subsequent videos, we'll talk about complex eigenvalues and about non-diagonalizable matrices. So here's the kind of system that we're talking about. We're looking at differential equations, and this is a 2x2 system. Let's keep it simple. Derivative of the first variable is three times the second variable. Derivative of the second variable is twice the first plus the second. And we'll take initial conditions, x of 1 is 6 and x of 2 equals 1. Now you can rewrite this in matrices. Say the derivative of the vector x1, x2 is this matrix times the vector. And our initial condition is the vector 6, 1. Now, this may look a little bit familiar. It should, because it behaves just like a system of difference equations. We've already studied systems of difference equations where x1 today is 3 times x2 yesterday, x2 today is twice x1 yesterday plus x2 yesterday. In those cases, with the same initial conditions, we had that x at any given time was a matrix times x the previous time, and we had the exact same initial conditions. So what we're going to do is we're going to solve both systems, the differential equations and the difference equations, in parallel. And I'm always going to use red ink for the differential equation and green ink for the difference equation. And the method is absolutely the same. The first step is that we want to diagonalize the matrix. We need to find our eigenvalues and our eigenvectors. And then we let y be the coordinates of x in the basis of eigenvectors. That's always going to be the right basis to use. Then we rewrite our equations in terms of y. We solve those equations. And then we convert the initial value of x into an initial value of y, into a final value of y, into a final value of x. That's the procedure that worked really well for our difference equations. It'll work just as well for our differential equations. So, step one. Step one doesn't care about whether it's difference or differential. It's diagonalizing the matrix. The sum of the rows is 3. So 3 is an eigenvalue. The trace is 1, so negative 2 is the other eigenvalue. And the eigenvectors are 1, 1, and 3, negative 2. So far, so good. So our basis is 1, 1, and 3, negative 2. And one of our change of bases matrices is 1, 3, 1, negative 2. And this is the inverse of that matrix. Next step is we write y is x in the b basis. And so we go from x to y by multiplying by PBE, that's this matrix. And what that means is that at any given time, well, x can be gotten by the opposite matrix, but that y1 and y2 are the coefficients when you expand x in the b basis. So x is y1 times b1 plus y2 times b2. That's what that means. Okay. Now let's rewrite our equations in terms of y. So since x can be expanded in terms of y, the derivative of x, I'm using the dot notation where dot means a time derivative, b1 and b2 are just fixed vectors, so the time derivatives are just y1 dot b1 plus y2 dot b2. Meanwhile, ax is a times y1 b1 plus a times y2 b2, and y1 is just a constant, it pulls out, and y2 is a constant, it pulls out. And b1 and b2 are eigenvectors. So ab1 is just 3b1, and ab2 is negative 2b2. And since our equations are that x dot is equal to ax, that means that y1 dot has to be 3y1, and that y2 dot has to be equal to negative 2y2. In general, if you do this for some other matrix, you're always going to get that the yj dot is the jth eigenvalue times yj. Now, when we did this for difference equations, it was the same sort of argument. We said x today is y1 today times b1 plus y2 today times b2. And x yesterday was the same thing, only we had y1 yesterday and y2 yesterday. The b's don't change. And a times x yesterday was given by y1 yesterday times ab1 plus y2 yesterday times ab2. And that was 3y1 b1 plus minus 2 y2 b2. And then we set this equal to this. These two are equal. And so we said, oh, y1 today must be 3y1 yesterday. y2 today must be negative 2y2 yesterday. And in general, if you had many eigenvalues, a bigger matrix, the jth y today is the jth eigenvalue times the jth y yesterday. Okay, so how do you solve these equations? Here's where things are different. The solution to y dot equals 3y is e to the 3t times the starting value. The solution to y dot equals negative 2y is e to the minus 2t times our starting value. Over here, the solutions were 3 to the n times the starting value and negative 2 to the n. So the only real difference is that here you exponentiate the eigenvalue times time. Here you take the nth power of the eigenvalue, e to the 3t versus 3 to the n, e to the minus 2t versus negative 2 to the n. And then we go around our square. And here's how we go around a square for the differential equation. We start off with initial value 6, 1. We multiply by P inverse, and we get 3, 1. Then we multiply the first coefficient by e to the 3t and the second coefficient by e to the minus 2t. So that's multiplying by e to the dt. And then we multiply by the matrix P. So we take the first y1 times the first eigenvector plus y2 times the second eigenvector, and we multiply it all out, and we get a solution. Now, if we'd done it for the difference equation, we would have just said 6,1 goes to 3,1 by P inverse, exactly the same as for the differential equation. The only difference is that on this stage, you're not multiplying by e to the dt, you're multiplying by d to the n. So you get 3 times 3 to the n, and 1 times negative 2 to the n. And then over here, you multiply by p to get the solutions. This is exactly the same as a solution to the differential equation, only with 3 to the n instead of e to the 3t, with negative 2 to the n instead of e to the minus 2t. There's the differential solution. There's the difference solution. Okay. And if you want to write these solutions in closed form, they look very much the same. For the differential equation, the solution is e to the at times the initial value. And how do you get e to the at? Well, it's p e to the dt p inverse times the initial value. P inverse times the initial value of x is the initial value of y. E to the dt times the initial value of y is the final value of y. And p times that is the final value of x. For the difference equation, we had a to the n instead of e to the at. We got that as p d to the n p inverse. The same p inverse, the same y of 0. D to the n instead of e to the dt, a slightly different y of n. And then we multiply by p to come home. Finally, the general solution to the differential equation. If I didn't give you initial conditions, but instead just said, what's the general solution? You would have said, it's a sum of terms, and each term is e to the lambda t times an eigenvector. And you have arbitrary coefficients, and these coefficients are really y1 of 0, y2 of 0, ym of 0. So this is the most general solution to the differential equation. the most general solution to the difference equation is the exact same thing, except instead of e to the lambda t, you have lambda to the n. That's it.